Welcome to Workplace Stories Podcast, a podcast on emotional journeys in the workplace to inspire people to live their life at the fullest, at work and beyond. I'm your host, Lison, certified mindset coach. You can subscribe to this podcast to hear more about courageous stories and thought leaders. Reach out if you want to share yours. Have a great time listening. Enjoy. Hi, today we are with an anonymous guest and we will talk about his stress to the workplace and then come back to the current situation and trends in leadership. Enjoy.
Hi there. Thank you for being with us today. So could you share with us what's been your path so far in the corporate?
Yes, hi. Definitely. I've been already a longer journey. And before that, I was more on the academic background. And therefore, there was a transition. Things were different from an academic to corporate. And therefore, there was a huge adaptation during that transition. And it's obviously, it's always the good sides and also the bad sides. I'll just summarize that the good sides is definitely the fulfillment in terms of the compensation and also like the ability to do a lot more work that I was doing before. That is definitely on the upside. But unfortunately, on the downside is that in particular in the industry where I'm working on, there's a lot of egos that one has to go through. And that creates situations that are not pleasant at all.
So which industry is it?
In the finance.
Mm-hmm. And when you say ego, what do you mean by that?
Yes, exactly. So this is something that is more towards the financial industry, where people refer to different personalities as egos, in the sense that there's a lot of competitive environment, and therefore sometimes is also almost as a bullfight between different people trying to impose their ideas or their way of see things instead of more in a collaboration, more as a brainstorming. In that respect, that is what is referred as egos. Like somehow very senior people have their already solid ideas and they don't want to change the way they do.
Okay. And now maybe as well, we can see in this modern world that being open-minded and flexible and adaptable to all the elements that are around us is in fact a way for us to thrive as well as an individual and as a team in corporation.
Absolutely. And the issue with the many corporations, basically those ones that were created a while ago, still fail to adapt to the new world and to the new type of leadership. And that is the conflict that we are witness as of now. Even from this case of people being told to work from home, there were a lot of managers that were not happy with the situation, somehow lost control of their team because now they have to become more as a leaders instead of as a managers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. Okay, let's go on these points a bit later. Could you tell us a bit more about what was your past and what was your main challenges in corporate and how it's been affecting you?
Yeah, I'll say like the biggest challenge was a while ago where I was in a position that was very demanding. And in that case, there was, again, a political fight between the two managers where I was reporting to. Mm-hmm. And because of that internal conflict and a kind of a fight for a power, there was one case that one of the manager was really like micromanaging others, but worse than that, really demanding a lot from the more junior people like myself to even be stay very late into the office and then go back in the very early morning. And all of a sudden, I was only sleeping about 6 hours a day, and I was supposed to do a work that demands focus and attention and also to avoid any mistakes. So you can imagine like going through 6 hours or even less of sleep per day, how the things can propagate by mid of the week or end of the week. And my concentration, my focus was very low and I started to make mistakes. And I was making mistakes. Then the person was even, you know, start to get more and more upset. Therefore, I was getting more anxious, and with that, I was even sleeping less, and it becomes a snowball effect.
Mm. And so what was the emotion that you felt?
Well, I felt like really that I was losing control, that I was not able to perform the job that I really wanted to perform well. It was really my dream type of job, and that I was not fulfilling the expectations of the others, and in a way that I was feeling myself as a loser.
Mm. Okay. And did it affect your colleague, like people outside of your work life as well?
Yeah, definitely, because as I was getting anxious, I was getting upset with myself and upset with the situation. Therefore, I was very negative. I was always complaining and trying to get reasons to come out of this situation. And therefore, I was looking only on the downside, on the negativity aspect of the things. And I was getting into a block in my mind that I was not able to get out of that. And that creates a lot of isolation at the same time. And I was not able to get the board that I like to, because I was at the same time isolating myself from the others.
How long was it ongoing?
Yeah, that was almost for a year. It was because at the same time, I'm a persistent person. So I was trying to give my best. In that situation, that was really maybe not advisable, because I should have done something different than try to be persistent.
Okay. And what was the strategy you used to get unstuck, or what was the situation that makes things change?
Well, the situation went so bad that I really could not even sleep more. And therefore, I just asked for a week off. In that week, then I traveled back to my home country, and then I started to get really support from a medical point of view. And this is where I got start to be unstuck, because then at least the doctor started to tell me things that were treating the symptoms, although I was not really treating the issue by itself, but at least position myself in a way that I could start to think in a different way how to solve the problem.
Okay. So once you get some awareness, how did you solve like the root cause of those symptoms?
Well, I had to realize that this type of job, this type of situation was not really for me. That was something that I could not afford to continue to go through. I had to really to give up, as bad as that mean to me and all my career. But regardless of persistence or willpower that I had, there was really no meaning for me to continue in that situation. And therefore, I started to contact other people to see what other opportunities I had in terms of a job.
Okay. So you looked outside of this company directly?
Yeah. Yes, exactly. Because unfortunately, I also contacted the HR department in that company. But I realized that they were not really interested for my problems. They were like more trying to protect themselves because of my position at the firm that was kind of a reasonable, visible, and therefore they wanted to minimize the impact on their side from my situation.
Okay. And did you ever do any online research regarding this type of issue?
Well, at the time there was probably not as much say help online as they are today, although it was not as long ago. The things were probably not as, the help that was out there was not probably as visible, but as well, because I was not even sure where to start. It's somehow when one gets into this block of mind, you just try to do the things that you only get at the first end. And it was like really just to start to go to a doctor. And then slowly, obviously, I started to look as well for other situations, even on the humankind, that it was a terrible situation for the people to live on. Try to compare myself with that situations. And although it seems a bit drastic, I was like then study a lot of the World War II, where people were really going through their lives and having that fear and that situation to go through, and start to compare my situation was nothing like that. So if those people were able to survive in that situation, so I should be able as well to go over my situation.
Okay. Interesting. Well, and before we move on the current situation, would you have any advice for someone that could go through a similar situation?
Well, definitely. I mean, the first thing is that not try to isolate it, because it becomes very easy people to be ashamed of himself or herself because it's not performing well at the job and believe that it's their fault. In reality, it's not necessarily their fault. It will be because of the environment, because of the circumstances. And there is nothing to be ashamed of, because there are many people that are going through this career challenge. And the best thing is really try to contact and enlarge the power, the network, and really kind of start to understand what other people are facing, because you'll be surprised that others will probably going through a similar situations, if not worse.
Yeah, you are not alone.
Exactly.
And in terms of recovery, what would be your advice?
Definitely looking for alternatives, because the issue with working in a corporate is that there is not much of alternatives, as one is looking into the job on the day-to-day. It becomes a lot of busyness, in the sense that you have to do a lot of work and you don't have then time to look for other things that will be either interesting to you or that will be as plan B or C to your career. So somehow, because of the activity, the demand on the day-to-day, somehow you almost lose track of time. And when you are ready at your free time, you become so tired that you can only just to go for a type of entertainment type of things, and not kind of a build as a plan B or plan C as an alternative if that job is not working for you. So really try to make that effort, even if it takes like 1 hour a day, to kind of either look for other alternatives or build something that is your plan B, your parachute in a way, if the things not go well where you are.
Yeah, that's right. So you're looking for what's next, but making sure as well that your mental capacity allow you to do so.
Exactly. So one thing that I'm doing more and more is physical exercise, because that's, I realized looking at the examples of special forces and the Marines in US. So I kind of follow certain people in there where I become my role models in a way, because these people, again, they are facing into a drastic situations. We are talking about war. Mm-hmm. And they have like techniques of reinforcing their mind and protect their mind from that environment. And this is, although it's unfair to compare the situations, because, you know, working in a corporate is not as bad, definitely, even in the worst case scenarios, as going to war. But there are definitely cases that you should protect your mind and use like these techniques that are being used, say, in the military to try to reinforce your mind. And that starts with the physical exercise. So at the moment, I'm doing a lot of resistance and certain exercises that are as well reinforcing my mind.
Okay. And so now let's talk about, you know, the current situation with the pandemic that is worldwide. So now we have to work from home. So how is it going for you?
It's going quite well, to be honest. And I know that many people fear of the consequence of the virus. By all means, we also have to be aware of the challenges that are coming next. But we also need to look at the benefits of being able to work from home in a certain way in an environment that is probably more protected, and then be in an open office environment where not only there is a lot of distractions, but then if you are in an environment, there's a lot of egos fighting with each other, it might not be beneficial to your, say, creativity or job fulfillment. So
indeed, yeah.
Exactly.
And what do you see as maybe some signs of a toxic workplace while working from home?
Well, the toxic environment is more because in an open office, if the things don't go well, it's enough to have two or three people that are not in agreement. And if they fail to put that disagreements in a more private way, and if they start to disagree in a more public way, everybody else listens to that. And that's kind of a negative environment. So that is really like the danger of an open office. People are not care enough to have their disputes or disagreements in a more kind of private place. And that is inevitable to happen, as well the distractions. So there's a lot of distractions going on with the noise, and people that prefer more use the focus and the creativity, they don't operate as well as if they are staying at home, where they're able to really have more focus and also think more deep about the problems.
Mm-hmm.
Really like what I'm experiencing, because now I can realize a lot of things that I can do from home that I was probably not able, in the sense of at least going into the deep of understanding the problems. Because now I'm not being interrupted as much, I can have my time really for myself to do that.
Mm-hmm. And the reverse, how the management is managing the activity?
So I am also a manager, and to me it's going well, because I always had the trust on the team. Mm-hmm. And I'm really happy that I did work with them before, because this transition from working from home makes totally sense to me. And yeah, I give total trust to them. So on my side, I see no issues. It's the opposite. There are even certain people that also, like me, were not totally happy from working on an open office environment with these like artificial lights, and it becomes a lot of challenging for them to manage their energy throughout the day. And now I see them working from home is also making more beneficial to their even health. Now, on the other hand, there is the other part of the management that they were not at all prepared for this situation in terms of being more a leader than as a manager.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, they have completely lost control or lost a sense of control, and they are more acting as a fear base than anything else.
Mm-hmm.
And start to micromanage others with total ridiculous type of asks or demands that we need to do on a daily basis, that is just demotivating everybody.
Can you give an example?
Yes, I mean, and this is not just on my side, this I see as well on other, even other companies. So it's nothing to do with the specific company that I work on. It's more with certain individuals.
Mm-hmm.
But we are, for example, asked to do kind of reports on a daily hour, what we have been doing every hour, just because of management wants to have a sense of control that we are not wasting time to do things that is not for their productivity, in their own words.
Mm-hmm.
And regarding that's kind of one way that is really treating people like almost as the robots.
Yeah, and as well, you mentioned, like, you work in the finance space. And I would say, how much time does it take for one person to make a report every hour? So at the end of the week, how many minutes, however, has been spent on just reporting about the
exactly.
Reporting?
Sometimes even some of us forget to do that or send these reports, because we are like more focused on other things that are much more relevant to the facing the challenge of the markets, because there's a lot of volatility that we feel that is not even necessary to do this, and is more not necessary. It's also, of course, the time, but it's more showing the signs that people are not trusting on us and they just want to control us and give instructions to do things that is really just disempowering us and believing that management has no trust on us and we are treated like a bit of as a children.
Yeah, so you say robots, children, demotivated. Maybe let's talk about the demotivation within a team, or what you can see, in fact, about the impact of that on people.
Yeah.
So can you tell us what's your perspective on the impact of those, I would call them, micromanagement strategies on people?
Well, it'll be interesting to see what it comes next when people are told to go work back again to the office, because I have a perception that things will not going to be the same as before, because now people have started to realize from this time of weeks, almost more than a month, start to realize that the ability to work from home and also like become more independent of all this micromanagement, and they probably want to put their own voice and to have like a say on the change of this type of culture. And it's more about the values and the principles, and if you agree or not with the what other people's values are. And I would foresee a bit of a clash, I'll say, when the things have to come back together as working again in the open office environment. And so it'll be interesting to see what's going to happen by that time.
Mm. Yes, indeed. To end up this talk, what would be the lesson that you would like to share with everyone that are listening to us?
Well, I have been thinking about that already for a while, even before the situation of the virus. And I think there is a bit of a belief, of a linear belief, in the sense that people are very focused on the productivity, on the profitability in a linear way. So all the targets, all the systems, all the methodologies are driven for the individual to meet that productivity. But we are dealing with human beings, not with machines.
Thank you for sharing. It was a bliss to hear about all those stories. Very courageous and very positive to see this leadership style in the corporate world.